Assalamu alaikum everyone, this is Mohammed Sohrab and you're watching EvolveSage Virtual Learning. Today we will discuss about data collection. What actually data collection is? The task of data collection started once you have determined your problem, okay? Once you have identified your research topic, once you have decided your population and you have selected your sample size, now it's time to collect necessary information related to that problem from your sample, okay? And that information can be in the form of numeric and it could be in the form of a descriptive statement, okay? And you will collect that information from the sample which you have selected for your study. While deciding about the methods of data collection to be used for study, a researcher should keep in mind that there are two types of data. One is primary data and then second is secondary data. Primary data is the data which is collected afresh and for the first time and it is original in characters, okay? And on the other hand, secondary data is the data which is collected by someone else and it is available in different platforms, okay? And that data is already gone through different statistical techniques and different statistical tools, okay? Now we can use that data for our studies as well, but it is totally depend on the authenticity of that data and validity of that data. If that data is valid, then we can use it for our studies, okay? So the major difference between primary data and secondary data is that primary data is collected first time and secondary data is the data which is already collected by someone else and we can use it for our studies. Now, which sort of data you will use for your study, it is totally depend on the nature of problem which you are going to discuss in your study. Like if I want to do a study on economy, then definitely that data will be a secondary data because that information will be available for me in different platforms like World Bank and IMF and on the website of that country as well. Now we will discuss about the collection of primary data, how we can collect primary data and what is the procedure to collect primary data. We collect primary data during the course of doing an experiment in experimental research, okay? If we are doing an experiment in experimental research, then we will collect primary data, okay? Like if I want to see the preference of customers, definitely I will go for primary data. There are several methods of collecting primary data, but important one are observations, interviews, questionnaires, projective techniques, and in-depth interviews, okay? These are the different methods through which we can collect primary data, okay? First of all, if we talk about observation, what actually observation is? The method of observation is commonly used methods in researches like behavioral sciences, okay? In a way, we all observe things around us, but every observation is not considered as scientific or observation. Observation became scientific tool of data collection when it serves a formulated research purpose, okay? Once we do research, once we do observation for research purpose, then that observation will be considered as scientific observation. Okay, under observation method, how we collect information through observation. Under observation method, researcher collect information directly without asking from respondent, okay? He just observe respondents and on the basis of his observation, he write the necessary information and he collect the necessary information. What are the advantages of this method? One of the biggest advantage of this method is that it reduce subjective bias. What does subjective bias mean? If we collect information through questionnaire, if we collect information through interviews, then maybe respondent avoid to provide that information which we can get through observations. Okay, so this reduces subjective biasness. Another advantage of this method is that this method is related to what currently happening with respondent. Okay, this is not about what he did in the past, what he did in the future, but on the basis of observation, we know what is the current condition with our respondent. Okay, and thirdly this method is very essential because this method is independent of respondent willingness. Okay, we don't require cooperation from respondent, and there is less involvement of respondent in this method. We require less cooperation from our respondents. So this method is comparatively a good method if we compare it with interviews or if we compare it with questionnaires. Second very important method of data collection is interviews. Okay, we also collect data through interviews. The interview method of data collection involves asking oral and verbal questions, okay, and getting responses in oral and verbal. Okay, so in this way we also collect necessary information that we have required during our research. Okay, and we only collect information from our selected sample. And this method could be used through telephonic interviews, and it could be used through personal interview. During personal interviews required a person known as interviewer. He will ask questions face to face to a person or different persons. And this sort of interviews may be in the form of direct personal interview. And this sort of interviews may be in the form of direct personal investigation, or it could be in the form of indirect oral investigation. When we say direct personal investigation, that means interviewer has to collect information personally from the concerned sources. He has to be on the spot and meet with the respondent from whom and data will be collected. Okay, in what I said, I'm repeating it again, in direct personal investigation, interviewer will meet with the respondents and he will collect information personally. Okay, and in indirect oral investigation, interviewer can select anyone else to collect that necessary information from the respondents. On the behalf of interviewer, a third person will collect that information from the interviewees, from the respondents. As in the same way, interviews could be structured or they could be unstructured. Structured interviews involve predetermined questions, okay, and standardized techniques which will used to collect necessary information from respondents. Okay, and interviews can be unstructured, like in unstructured interviews, respondents are not asked structured questions or predetermined questions, but respondents are asked frequent questions on his given statement. Like if a respondent responds that I like to eat this food on Saturday, then interviewer can ask him why you are writing this statement in this way. So in unstructured interviews, interviewer can ask frequent questions. Okay guys, another method of data collection is questionnaires. What does questionnaire mean? This method is quite popular in the case of having big inquiries. In this method, a questionnaire is sent to the concerned person with a request to answer the questions and return back this questionnaire. And this questionnaire consists of number of questions which are related to the variables which were used in the study. Okay, the variable which we used in study, we make questions related to those variables, and then these questions are part of questionnaires which is being filled by the respondents. So these are the different important methods which we have discussed today. Okay, in our second video, we will discuss about the secondary data collection method and how we collect secondary data and how we utilize it. We will discuss it in our upcoming video.